Seems to me it's been brought to my attention that there's a lot of wrestlers in this area that would like to get their hands on me in the ring. Well, I'm a manager. I manage the best in professional wrestling today. I have a new member of my family right now, Professor Toro Tanaka. And there's also a few guys around here that happen to think they're experts in martial arts. As far as I'm concerned, they're not. If anybody wants a piece of me, they're going to have to go through this gentleman right here. Now, this man is 285 pounds. Professor Toro Tanaka. They call him the professor because he's a master in the martial arts. Any way you want to take it, any kind of martial arts, this man's a master of them. He can kill, he can maim with his hands, his elbows, his feet, and his head. Now, I'd like to show you what this man is capable of. You're very impressed with what you saw, and if any of you wrestlers that think you're so tough and so great would like to back out now that have already signed contracts, you may do so. I will completely understand. These are also called nunchucks. They're from the Philippines, they're from the Far East, they're from Okinawa. 360 degrees, these can turn at any angle, any direction. This man right here, Professor Tanaka.
Friday night at the Omni in Atlanta, Bob, that's the man you're facing.
That's it. He's a deadly human being, no doubt about it. But I heard Bobby Heenan say one thing that I've been trying to get to him, and I'm going to get to you, Heenan, sooner or later. Now, Tanaka is the baddest dude in martial arts in the world, and nobody denies that. I'm not an expert, but I ain't no dummy like those boards either. I ain't going to lay there and let you hit me. I'm going to be skipping and zipping and moving and grooving, and I don't care how big you are, Tanaka, if I hit you just right with one of my karate boys.
Tremendous skill, tremendous ability. Chick Donovan, a second-generation athlete. Drop toe hold, takedown. And it's Donovan trying to roll out of it, trying to sit out and escape. Gets that side headlock, but look at Anderson. Into the ring ropes. Into the ring ropes. The referee calls for the break. Anderson now with that side headlock on Chick Donovan. And a good escape by Donovan into a hammerlock. Anderson again utilizing the ring ropes. That's the second time. Donovan catching him on the break, and I can't say that I blame him. He knows full well what to expect from a man like Anderson. Ole tried to reach out the tag, but too far away from Ernie the Cat Ladd. Now moves in. The tag is made. 6'9", Ernie the Cat Ladd. 5 years all-pro in the NFL. Hip toss by Ernie the Cat Ladd. Say hello to all the good folks in Bloomington, Minnesota, who watch us each week here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. Nice to hear from the folks in Bloomington, the home of the mighty Vikings and the Twins. Into the ropes. The referee calls for the break. And it's Donovan in trouble on those ropes. Anderson standing clear, not interfering. Ernie the Cat Ladd caught in a side headlock and momentarily staggered by Donovan. Donovan unloads and he makes the tag. Allen goes in. Allen, good flying drop kick. Drove Ladd backwards. Allen closes in again. Allen with a series of punches now. It is Ernie Ladd. Makes the tag with Ole Anderson. Anderson moves in. Anderson with that side headlock now. Allen caught the end of those ropes. Good forearm by Allen. Another one. Anderson now front face lock. A quick mention of our crew right now on cameras. Henry Matthews, Susan Chance, Ron Sutton, and Marcus Sharp. On video, Ernie Watts, Ron Jeter, and Leo Harris. On audio, Cynthia Tyler. My director is Mike Allen. Into those ropes once again. Ted Allen into that far turnbuckle. Anderson makes the tag with Ernie the Cat Ladd. And the Cat moves in. Over 300 pounds. Caught him with that size 14 coming in. That's the thing about Ladd. But now, look at... Allen fighting back gamely. Anderson starts to come into the ring. Ladd catches him. Shoulder block coming in. Ladd whips him off. Caught him with that foot once again. Allen tried to stave it off, but to no avail. Now down across him, it is all over. And so Ernie the Cat Ladd and Ole Anderson victorious in their match against this combination. And one certainly cannot deny the great strength, the great skill and ability of Ole Anderson and Ernie the Cat Ladd.
Georgia's Championship Wrestling, the outstanding wrestlers in the world today, brought to you each and every week. Now, here's your host,
weighing in at 270 pounds, the sweet soul, the American Dream, former world champion, Dusty Rhodes.
Dusty Rhodes, of course, he is also the U.S. champion. And here's a man who is perhaps one of the most charismatic wrestlers that I have ever known. And he, of course, will be talking to him in an interview that I did with him earlier, immediately following this match. I have a pre-recorded interview that I did with Dusty earlier in the day. So we'll be seeing that after this match. But right now we're going to be watching... Rhodes moves in against Rose. Full body slam. Dusty Rhodes, Boston, Texas. Arm drag takedown. Rhodes has a great strength, great power, and very fast for a man his size, exceptionally fast. It's also quite a background on Rhodes. He's an outstanding football player, outstanding baseball player. Had pro contracts and offers both in pro baseball, pro football, and pro wrestling. And because of the very independence of his nature, chose the sport that he really loves the best, and that, of course, is pro wrestling. And, of course, he has become one of the most sought-after wrestlers in the world today. Rose having his problems now with Dusty Rhodes. Into those ropes. Forearm into the chest. Another one, and one under the jaw. Rhodes fires back, catches him with an elbow, drives him to the canvas. Dusty Rhodes now closing in on his man. Rhodes brings him up high, high, vertical souffle. Crashes down. The American Dream. Inflicting a lot of punishment there. Brings him up a full body slam. Dusty Rhodes crashes down with that bionic elbow. And it is all over. It is all over. Dusty Rhodes victorious in his match here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. As I said, of course, we did have an earlier interview pre-recorded with Dusty Rhodes talking about his very, very close friend, Tony Atlas. So at this